Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we are writing a program to find out the GCD of two numbers. So GCD is nothing but greatest common divisor. GCD of two positive number is nothing but it is the greatest number which will divide both the number completely. For example, if I take 12 and 14, if you want to find out the GCD of these two numbers, then first we need to find out the divisor of this number, that is the number which will divide this number completely, that is the divisor of 12 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12, right? This number will divide this number completely, which will give remainder as 0. Next, coming to the 14, that is 1, 2, not 3, not 4, not 5, not 6, 7 and 14. Okay, these are the divisor of this number. Now we need to find out the common divisor from this. So here we can see 1 and 2 are the common divisor in these divisors. So here the greatest number is 2, so the GCD of 12 and 14 is 2. Okay, it is the greatest number which will divide both the numbers completely, right? GCD is also called as HCF, stands for highest common factor. Both are same. Okay, to find out the GCD of two numbers, first we need to find out the divisor, next we need to pick the common divisor, next we need to find out the greatest common divisor, right? But if you take bigger number, then it is not easy to find out the divisor of that number, right? So instead of this method, we can use Euclid's algorithm to find out the GCD of two numbers. Euclid is a mathematician who gave an algorithm to find out the GCD of two numbers. Okay, so now we'll see Euclid's algorithm to find out the GCD of two numbers. Algorithm name is Euclid's algorithm, okay, or Euclidean algorithm. And according to this Euclid's algorithm, if we take two numbers, for example 64 and 48, the first step is we need to take the bigger value. So here 64 is greater than 48. So first I'll take 64 is equal to, here I'll write smaller number, that is 48. Here we need to find out the x value. How many times 48 will be equal to 64? Next, here I need to mention the remainder. So here after this, here 64 into 48, ones are 48, okay, remainder is 16, right? So now we need to move this value to the left side. So that's nothing but this value is destroyed and 48 will move here, okay, is equal to 16 will move here, 16, and we need to check how many times 16 is equal to 48. Next, here I need to mention the remainder. 16, 3 is a 48, right? So we can mention 16 into 3 and remainder as 0. Okay, here again this value is destroyed and 16 will move here, okay, and this 0 will move here. Okay, when we'll get this value as 0, then this will be the GCD of that two numbers. Okay, so here 16 is the GCD of 64 and 48. This is the greatest number which will divide both this number completely. So next we'll take another example. I'll take 4 and 18. Okay, so first I need to take the bigger value, that is 18 is equal to 4 into, I need to mention how many times 18. 4 4s are 16, right? So remainder is 2. Okay, next this is destroyed and here 4 will move here, is equal to 2 will move here, so 2 2s are 4, right? So remainder is 0. Next, again this is destroyed and 2 will move here, is equal to 0, will move this remainder here, right? So here we got 0, that So that means 2 is the greatest divisor of 4 and 18. So GCD of 4 and 18 is 2. Okay, so this is the method to find out the GCD of 2 numbers. So now we'll write the program to find out the GCD of 2 numbers. Okay. First one is we can use a predefined function which is defined in the math module, that is called as GCD. So to use that, we need to import math module. Next, you can write math.gcd in the lowercase. Here we need to mention the two values. So if I mention 4 and 18, just now we calculated this, right? That is 2. Okay, here you can write math.gcd of 64 and 48, that is 16. Okay, so this is the one way we can use a predefined function and we can calculate the GCD of 2 numbers. Next, if you don't want to use this GCD function, then we can write a program using recursive function. So to write that, first we need base case and recursive case, right? So I'll take same example, that is 64 and 48. Okay, so I'll write this as larger number, 64 is equal to 48 into x plus remainder. So suppose if I take this 64 as A and 48 as B, this is A, here we'll write B, and this is nothing but A modulus B, right? We'll get the remainder when we use modulus operation, right? So we use modulus operator here. So remainder is nothing but A modulus B, okay? So now here 64 is equal to 48 ones are plus 16 is remainder. Okay, in the next step what we will do, we will shift the value to the left side. This is destroyed and we'll move 48 here and 16 here. Okay, 16 threes are and remainder here. So that is nothing but, actually this was the value of B, right? So here A value was 64, B value as 48. A modulus B value was 16 right here. So but here we can see A value becomes B. 48 is the value of B, right? But here in this step A value becomes B and B value becomes this. This is the remainder, that is nothing but A modulus B, right? This is the recursive case. A value becomes B and B value becomes A modulus B. Next, here again this 48 will be destroyed and 16 will move here and this 0 will move here. So this is the B value, okay? These are all the B values, and when B value becomes 0, this is the GCD, that is nothing but A value. So our base case is when B value becomes 0, return A. Okay, A is the GCD of that numbers. Okay, so we got the base case and recursive case. So now we'll write the program. Okay, so in the Python file, first we'll define a function. So here we are using the recursive function. So first we need a function, right? So I'll take my function name as compute GCD. Next here I'll take A comma B. Okay, so these are the parameters. Next here, first I need to take the base case, right? If B becomes 0, then return A. Okay, so when the B value becomes 0, we'll return the A value as the GCD of that number, right? Next here we need to write the recursive case, that is else return compute GCD. Okay, here A value becomes B, so B, and B value becomes A modulus B, right? We'll shift the value towards the left, then A value becomes B and B value becomes A modulus B, that is remainder, right? This is our recursive case, and here we can see this function calls itself, that's why it is called as recursive function. Next, I'll come out of this function and here I'll ask the user to enter the two input. Here I use input function to take the input from the user, And in the Python 3, we know input function by default take input as the string value. But here we want integer value. That's why I'll convert the string input to integer. Here we can see I used int function for that. Okay. Next, I'll take second value. So this is the second number. Next here, print, I'll call compute GCD, and here num1, num2. Okay, so now I'll save this and run this. So enter the first number. If I enter 64 and 48, the GCD is 16. Okay, so now if I enter 4 and 18, GCD is 2. Okay, so here, so when we'll enter the first number as 4 and second number as 18, so it will execute the print function. Here we can see the function call. So num1 value is 4 and num2 value is 18. So control will go to the function definition. Here a value become 4 and b value become 18. So first it will check whether b value is equal to 0. No, it is not, because b value is 18. 18 is not equal to 0. So it will go to the else part, and then it will see the function call a value is b. So b value is 18. So here this is 18. Next, this is remainder. So that is nothing but 4 modulus 18. That is nothing but 4. Okay. So b value is 18. This is 4. Again, we can see the function call. So it will again execute this function with the a value as 18 and b value as 4. Again, it will check whether b value equal to 0. No, it is not. So it will execute the else part. Here b and a modulus b. B value is 4 and a modulus b, so that is 18 modulus 4, that is 2. Okay, so here a value is 4 and b value is 2. Again, it will check b is equal to 0. No, so it will come here. So here b value is 2, a modulus b, so that is nothing but 4 modulus 2, that is 0. So here a modulus b becomes 0. So again, it will execute this. Here a value is 2 and b value is 0. So it will check if b is equal to 0. Yes, it is true. So it will return the value of a, that is nothing but 2. That's why we got 2 in our output. Here we can see. Okay, so this is the program to find out the GCD of two numbers. Okay, so that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.